Welcome to another edition of County Connection. I'm your host, Berks County Commissioner Christian Leinbach, and the topic on today's show is the Berks County Library System and how it relates to you and your local library. My guest on today's show is Amy Resh, and Amy is the director of our Berks County Library System. Welcome.
Well, thank you so much for having me.
It is great to have you on the show. And what I'd like to do today is to share with our viewers what the Berks County Library System does, its purpose, how it relates to local libraries, but then really talk about a lot of the benefits that the library system provides. But let's start with you.
Okay.
You're relatively new to the position of director. Berks County Library is a little bit over a year.
Yes, at this point it's been about a year and a half now.
What got you interested in libraries? We joked a little bit before the program that maybe you were walking along one day and a book fell on your head and you said, I'm going to be a librarian. But what got you interested
in libraries?
Well, it
wasn't quite that.
Not quite like that?
No, but I was originally going to become a teacher, mm-hmm. and I thought that the best way to really spread information was by being a librarian, because libraries are open to everybody. And that's one of the things that I think is most valuable about libraries, is that we don't exclude people, that we want everybody to come and join us. If we have a library in your community, we want mm-hmm. you in our library.
Benjamin Franklin.
Yes.
The first free library in America in Philadelphia. He believed libraries should be free.
Yep.
So what did you do? You decided you wanted to be involved in libraries. What did you do?
So after that, I finished my degree at Kutztown, my undergraduate degree, and then I went to Drexel University for my master's degree in library and information science, and took a long, windy road, but then I became a director of a library, and I enjoyed it, and became a director of another library. And
here in Berks County.
My first director job was at the Boone Area Library in Birdsboro, and then after that I went to the Emmaus Library, mm-hmm. Which is in the Lehigh Valley. And I did an expansion project there for $1.5 million, and that was really interesting and different, but I knew that I wanted to do something bigger. I wanted to have a bigger impact. So this position opened up. I decided, well, shoot, I think I could do that.
Well, I remember interviewing you for this position, and not to talk about age discrimination, but I saw your resume, and just looking at graduation, boy, this lady is a young lady. I wonder if she's ready for this.
Yeah.
You blew me out of the water in your face-to-face interview with the commissioners.
So
I think you interviewed with two of us, Commissioner Barnhart mm-hmm. and myself.
That's correct.
And then had another interview with the third commissioner.
Sure.
But what came through? Is your passion?
Oh, well, yes. I feel really strongly about libraries. I think that we're so lucky to live in a place where we have such great library service. And actually, I graduated from Exeter in high school, and we were fortunate to have the Exeter Community mm-hmm. Library. And I really grew up with a great library, and I thought it was just so important as a real heart of the community that so many people could go there and be accepted mm-hmm. and welcomed. And so I feel really lucky to be able to do that now is my career.
It's especially important, and any young people especially that might be watching, figure out what your passion is, follow up on that passion, get the education you need, because Amy is proof, following your passion means that you get to go to work every day and it's not really work. It doesn't mean you don't have challenges.
And it doesn't mean that it's not a large part of your life, but I definitely feel, like I said, very lucky to be able to go to a job every day where I feel like I'm able to make a difference.
And you have.
Oh, thank you.
We meet, I think, on a quarterly basis.
Yes, we do.
Your passion comes through in the work that you do, the planning that you do, and that's vitally important. So let's start by talking about the Berks County Public Library System.
Okay.
When I say that to the general public, I think many people think, oh, That's the group that owns and operates all the libraries in Berks County. But that's not really what the Berks County Library System is or does. So tell us, what is the core role of the library system?
So the library system in Berks is a federated system. So what that means is all the libraries are owned and operated locally. But we've all decided to work together. So the system does a lot of things like delivery. So we deliver the items from library to library. We do a lot of facilitation between the libraries. And then one of the most important things that we do is the cataloging for the libraries. So every Berks County library that is a member of the system gets those benefits for being a member of the system. But the system, you're right, doesn't own any buildings. We don't tell any libraries what to do. We just say this is a best practice, but we don't tell them what to do. Well, I think it's better that way.
I think it is too. In fact, we have contracts with each of the libraries between the Berks County Library System and the individual libraries. Yeah. And within those contracts, and I've looked at them, it makes it very clear each library is independent and autonomous.
Yep.
So when we look at the library system, the governance of the Berks County Library, how does that work? Who's on the board, not by name, but are they representatives of all the member libraries, or is it something different?
So it's really interesting. Actually, we have a 7-member advisory board, and they work with me to create policy and procedure for the system, but they're appointed by you, the commissioners. So, and then we have an advisory council, and that's actually made up of board members from the member library. So they attend our board meetings so that they know what we're talking about and they have input. Let's say we want to do something that they don't like. Well, we want to hear from them. But that's what's so great about all of the libraries being autonomous is that the local library really is representative of their local community. So we're not looking at things from a county perspective. Those local libraries are saying our population is X and we want to do this program or have these materials because they want it.
And some of the programming over time changes.
Oh, definitely.
Probably two great examples are the bookmobile, which was gone before you started, but it was here when I became a commissioner 12 years ago. And then more recently, the Bookosaurus. The bookmobile really dates back to a very different time when there were only a handful of libraries in the county.
Yes.
And it traveled around the county to provide access where there were no local libraries. I don't know what year it was, but it was in my first term. The bookmobile was going to, was end of life, and it was had to be replaced. It was $250,000
They're not
just
cheap.
To buy the bookmobile. And so we asked for some data comparing to the usage 20, 30 years ago and the usage today and what communities it was going into. And they were going into communities where there was already either a local library and without a doubt, libraries in elementary schools and high schools. It was a tough decision. But we eliminated the bookmobile. We kept the money in the budget. A little bit tougher was Bookosaurus. And the Bookosaurus was a little bit different. It was similar in that it came to end of life. And we were going to have to replace a vehicle, not at $250,000 but significant nonetheless. But we asked the question, what are we doing? And we were largely taking good people. We had staff going into local schools and reading to students. And we said, is that really a good use of our money in our county library
system? Is that our role?
Is that our role? And those are some of the tough decisions that we have to make, focusing on the core of what we do. So before we get into some of the benefits, let's talk about the funding. On two levels. The funding that is shown in the county budget really comes from two sources. The state money comes in and is matched with the county money. So roughly how much is that on an annual basis?
So as state funding, the system receives $1.2 million, which sounds like a lot of money, but we have a large number of member libraries. We also get $300,000 in county coordination aid, which is a state match because the county is generous and gives us funding for libraries. And then the county gives about $2 million in direct library support. So that money goes straight to the libraries in the system.
So you're just under $4 million combined.
Yes.
That's coming to the system.
Mm-hmm.
And then that money is allocated by formula to the various local libraries.
Yep.
Before we talk about how local libraries, in addition to that money, gain money, let's just touch on the fact that not every local library is a member of the system. Why Missing, for instance, is not, by choice, a member of the Berks County Library System.
Right, it's not a bad thing.
It's not a bad thing.
It's just a choice that local libraries make.
Correct.
So that's all.
So we don't want our viewers to assume that every library in Berks County is tied in to the Berks County Library System.
You're right. But because we
are
a system, even if you live in those municipalities that have libraries outside the system, you're fortunate enough to be able to come to any library that is a system library and get a library card. And of course, we encourage people to do that.
So local libraries, they get a portion by formula of the money that comes from the state and the county.
Yep.
Where else do they get funding from?
So the other funding sources are local municipal funding. And so
library tax?
Sometimes. Actually, we're one of the counties that there are very few library taxes. But so it's usually by appropriation. So if you like your library and you want higher municipal funding, you would go to your municipality and say, I support the library, I love the library, and I want the library to get more of your money. Or our money, as it is.
Sure.
The other way is by fundraisers. A lot of our libraries have really generous friends groups, so they're really fortunate. But a lot of them do quite a lot of fundraising. And fines and fees actually make up less than 5% of most library budgets.
But I'm sure anyone that's had to pay their fines.
It is
tough. Or they have a dream that they found this book that they borrowed when they were 12 years old and now they're 75.
Don't worry, they wouldn't charge you the full fees.
So, but the crux of the money, state, county is the largest overall contributor to that, and that's county tax dollars.
Yes, it is.
And then it's municipal funding, fundraisers, and in a minimal level.
A very, very small amount of fines and fees.
Now, an exception to that is there are some libraries, Boyertown Community Library comes to mind. They have a very successful passport program where they can put together new or renew passports for people in their area. I know that financially it's been good.
Sinking Spring is another one, as well as Kutztown, and all of those do that, and it is a great revenue stream, and those luckies are those libraries are very fortunate to be able to have an additional revenue stream, but it does also cost them in the way of staff time to run those services.
So we spend money. What do we get? What are some of the benefits of the Berks County Library System working in conjunction with local libraries?
So The biggest benefit that most people know about is that they can walk into their library, and usually their library is the heart of the community, or is a place that is open to all, has a lot of things that they can borrow, such as physical materials like books and DVDs. They have programs for children, they have programs for adults. Our Summer Quest program is one of our most popular programs. And in 2019, we had over 42,000 adults, teens, and kids participate. But they also have things like digital materials.
Sure.
So our digital materials on OverDrive or the Libby app, it depends on which one you have. Those are paid for out of a pot of money that we all kind of share and spend together, county coordination aid. And those are things like ebooks, e-audiobooks, which if you ever had to buy an ebook or an e-audiobook, those get really pricey really fast. So that's a huge benefit.
$15 to $20 plus dollars.
Yes.
But it goes to the heart of libraries are not about ink on paper.
Oh, definitely.
Libraries are about information and, relatively speaking, free access to that information. And Berks County is doing a great job. What are some of the other benefits people experience?
Well, I was going to say some of the other benefits. I wrote some notes because there's so many things that we do. They're also going to be working with the 2020 census. And that's one thing that a lot of people in mm-hmm. Berks County, we have about 20% of our population, doesn't have at-home internet access. Mm-hmm. So we call it the digital divide. And so one of the things that libraries really excel at is offering free Wi-Fi and free computers. So you can go there if you have a device and you want to connect, or if you don't have a device and you need the internet, so such as you're doing your census, you need help with that, or you want to learn how to read, you want to learn about your genealogy.
Work on homework.
There you go.
You don't have access to the internet at home, you have it. And I think virtually all of our libraries have that internet access.
Oh, yes, all of them do.
Everyone that I've been in and used
every
heavily.
Every single one.
You might be job hunting.
Yes.
And today, almost every company
all
that
online.
Is doing job search, looking for employees, it's online. You've got to be able to access. And if you're new to the online status, the librarians and staff in the libraries can help a person
A lot of our libraries even have computer classes where they'll teach people that have never used computers. I know the Reading Public Library, their reference staff are hugely helpful to a lot of people that have, let's say they were incarcerated or they had a job for a long time and then they were laid off. They've never actually had to use a computer to fill out an application. So all of the libraries are more than happy to help with that. But I know RPL's reference staff is just above and beyond. They've really helped a lot of people get on their feet again.
And RPL,
Reading Public Library.
RPL is the largest library in the system. And it's obvious why they're in the largest municipality in the county,
a
little over 88,000 to 90,000 people. There's really no other municipality close to And they have multiple branches.
So they have the three branches in their main location.
Right.
But I think that that's really important because they have a lot of people that don't drive or they don't have access to a car. Maybe they know how to drive. They just, there's nowhere to park it. So I think that having...
Urban life is about, if I don't need a vehicle, I don't want one.
Yep. So I think that it's really important for them to have the multiple locations. But every single one is, every single library in Berks County, I've visited every one, including the ones that aren't in our system, and they're all just fantastic.
So when I look at benefits, one of the things that we talked about prepping for the show, it's hard for some people to get time to sit down with a book.
Sure.
I'm one of those people. For literally years, I've read with a book on my nightstand, and I would open the book, you go to bed, and maybe get a chapter.
Yep.
But often, not even get a chapter in, fall asleep, or I'm too tired to keep going, close the book. And it would take me, and almost embarrassed, a year to read a book and a half.
Mm-hmm.
Last February, my wife said to me, I have an idea for you. Now, I'd love to say it was she turned me on to the library app, although she uses it.
She does.
She said, why don't you try Audible, one of the competitors that costs real money?
Yes.
For me, that has been a godsend. I shared with you, I'm on my 19th book since the end of last February, and I am absolutely thrilled with what I've been able to pick up. Primarily history, primarily American history, but I've listened to four books by David McCullough. My entertainment is Louis L'Amour, his Westerns, although one of them is more of a 20th century Cold War novel, but a lot of history, plain honest men talking about the writing of the Constitution, and it helped reintroduce me to the value of learning from reading And reading doesn't always have to be ink on paper.
Definitely not.
And our libraries have a variety of options. You mentioned that before, but
yes.
I think we want to reiterate
Definitely.
To our folks that it's not just about coming in and checking out a book. It's about learning.
Definitely. It's lifelong learning.
Lifelong learning. It's about DVDs. They can be entertainment. They can be educational.
Right.
Audiobooks. All types of options.
Yeah, I think that that's what's really important for people to realize that there are so many wonderful things at libraries, and if you haven't stopped by in a while, I think you'd be really surprised at the offerings that your local library has, in addition to what your local library is just doing in the community.
So what does it save us as
consumers? last year, the library system, this isn't any library outside of the system, but the library system saved Berks County users $31 million, and that's not including digital items. That mm-hmm. only includes items that were physically checked out, books, DVDs, music. It doesn't include the programming that our libraries offer. It doesn't include the space, the internet, nothing. It's just
materials.
It's what
they saved if they had purchased or rented
yep.
Those items. And for the record, we talked about it before, the total money being put in from the state and the county is under $4 million.
Right.
So the county library system is a very, very good deal. From my standpoint, I think
Definitely.
Benjamin Franklin would be proud of our library
system. It's a wonderful return on investment. I think that there's no better investment in the world than education. And I think that's one thing our libraries do really well.
Absolutely. So in the minute or so we have left, what you like to tell our viewers about the Berks County Public Library System?
Okay. I would like to let them know that their local libraries are really a reflection of their community. And if they want something that their library doesn't have, that they should go talk to their library director. They're very open. They want to do things that their community thinks is important and valuable. And I also want to remind people that if they do stop by the library and check out an item, at the bottom of their receipt, it will tell them how mm-hmm. much they saved on that trip. So I think that that is just one of the most important things that you can see right when you leave the library, tangible evidence of how much your library saved you.
Well, thank you very much for being on our show today,
no
Amy.
No problem.
You did a great job.
Thanks.
And for you, our viewers, I hope that you've learned a lot more about libraries in general, but more specifically, what the Berks County Library System does. It's the structure that helps each of the libraries share material with each other so they can share it with you. If you haven't checked out your local library recently, maybe now's the time in the new year to write it down, go visit your local library, see what they have to offer you. Thank you for joining me for another edition of County Connection. I'm your host, Berks County Commissioner Christian Leinbach, saying goodbye, and I look forward to seeing you the next time.